Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss on the topic of free body diagrams, where we have got a body B and there are different forces acting on this body along different directions in the xy plane. So starting with the analysis, we first take the horizontal forces that act on this body. Those are F and G. These forces are acting in directions opposite to each other. Hence the net resultant force along the horizontal, that is Rx, will be equal to the difference of F and G. Similarly, if we take the vertical forces that act on this body, we have got W and N. These forces again act in directions opposite to each other. So the net resultant force along the vertical Ry will be the difference of W and N. Had they been acting in the same directions, we would add the forces together. So now we have got this body B and the net resultant along the horizontal and vertical are known to us. So to calculate the resultant of all the four forces, we'll find the resultant R. That is the vectorial addition of Rx and Ry. So the magnitude of this force R is given by the formula R square equals Rx square plus Ry square, and the direction is given by the angle phi, where tan phi is Ry by Rx. So now we take a look at a force F that is not aligned along the horizontal or vertical, but it's acting at an angle theta to the horizontal. In that case, we find the horizontal component Fx, that is F cos theta, and the vertical component will be Fy, that is F sin theta. So this is useful for any force that acts on a body not aligned to the horizontal or vertical, but at a different angle. So this is called resolution of the vectors, where we find the horizontal and the vertical component. So let's take an example first, where a body B is acted upon by three random forces F, G and H, and they are acting at different angles. For example, F at angle theta to the horizontal, G at an angle alpha to the horizontal, and H at an angle 0 degree to the horizontal. So in this case, we need to resolve the forces individually and then find the net resultant on the body B. Starting with F, we find that the horizontal component for F will be Fx, that is F cos theta, and the vertical component Fy will be F sin theta, as we have seen earlier. Similarly, for the force G, we'll have Gx as G cos alpha, and for Gy, we'll have G sin alpha. And finally, in the case of H, we'll have Hx equals to H cos 0, which will be equal to H. And Hy will be H sin 0, which will be equal to 0, because cos 0 is 1 and sin 0 is obviously 0. So now if we club all the forces that act in the horizontal direction together, we have got Fx, Gx and Hx. So considering the directions of the individual forces, we get the net resultant Rx as Fx plus Gx minus Hx. Similarly, for the case of the vertical forces, we have Fy, Gy and Hy, where Hy is obviously 0. So the net resultant will be the difference of Fy and Gy. So now for the body B, the net resultant force R acting on it will be the vector addition of Rx and Ry. And again, the magnitude of R will be given by the formula R square equals to Rx square plus Ry square. And the direction will be given by the angle phi, which is the angle between R and the horizontal, by the formula tan phi equals to Ry by Rx. So this is how we analyze the effects of different forces on a body with the help of the free body diagram. Thank you guys.